humankind has always been driven to explore and discover. The desire to learn, see, and know more lives within each of us. In the early 1600s, this drive led several men to experiment with glass lenses and create a device that you could look through and see images magnified up to 3 times their normal size. This device was one of the first steps in creating modern inventions like the microscope and the telescope. Galileo Galilei, a famous scientist and engineer, heard about this new invention and, without even seeing it, immediately began to build his own version. Galileo made significant improvements to the design and was able to achieve magnifications of 20 times an object's size. However, while others used these rudimentary telescopes to study the natural world around them, Galileo was the first to point his skyward. An entirely new world was revealed. With his telescope, Galileo studied the moon in detail, noting its cratered surface and phases as it orbited the Earth. He also discovered the rings around Saturn and moons around Jupiter. The telescope, along with its counterpart, the microscope, was pivotal in helping humankind understand that what we see with our naked eye is only a very small part of the world we live in. In the intervening 4 centuries since Galileo's discovery in 1609, the telescope has been refined, reformed, and reinvented, allowing us to peer deeper and deeper into the black expanse of space. Today, you can purchase a relatively inexpensive telescope and see for yourself the same stars that entranced Galileo 400 years ago. However, scientists quickly realized that to see farther into space, their instruments would need to be significantly larger. Over the years, telescopes have evolved from simple handheld devices to huge, complex machines directed by computers. Now, massive telescopes dot the Earth from the Chilean desert to the mountaintops of Hawaii. They are even found in space, orbiting the Earth. Let's take a look at how far the telescope has come by studying 3 of the most famous telescopes in the world. The Atacama Large Millimeter Array, or ULMA for short, is a large group of radio telescopes. Stars, black holes, and other space phenomena give off radio waves. And these radio telescopes allow us to receive these waves and learn more about the stars in the process. ULMA was built in the Atacama Desert in northern Chile at an elevation of 5,000 meters or 16,000 feet. The high elevation of the area, coupled with the low humidity, is ideal for receiving clear signals. The telescopes are actually mobile and can be moved up to 16 kilometers or 10 miles to be positioned correctly. Working together, they act like the zoom lens on a camera, allowing for beautifully detailed images. Perched atop the dormant volcano Mauna Kea on the island of Hawaii sits the W.M. Keck Observatory with its twin telescopes Keck 1 and Keck 2. Located near the equator and at an elevation of 4,145 meters or nearly 14,000 feet, Mauna Kea makes an ideal location for astronomical observation. Each telescope is housed inside an insulated dome and measures 10 meters or 32 feet across and weighs an astounding 300 tons. Each telescope utilizes a mirror made up of 36 individual segments, and this mirror can be moved 2,000 times every second, allowing astronomers to cancel out atmospheric distortion. This creates images that are 10 times clearer. Perhaps you've noticed that these telescopes have all been located at high elevations. This is to reduce distortion caused by our atmosphere. Scientists realize that this problem could be avoided by stationing a telescope in space, out of our atmosphere completely. Let's turn our attention to arguably the most famous telescope in the world, the Hubble Space Telescope. Launched into low Earth orbit in 1990 as one of the first space telescopes, the Hubble Telescope is still operational today. It weighs in at 11,000 kilograms or 24,000 pounds and is the length of a large school bus. It is powered by two 25-foot solar panels, but it uses surprisingly little power, just slightly more wattage than it takes to run a toaster. Hubble is one of the most prolific telescopes operating today, sending back about 120 gigabytes of data each week. That's as much information as you would find in a stack of books 1,000 meters or 3,600 feet tall. Humankind's fascination with exploration and discovery remains undiminished today. Like Galileo, we are driven to learn and grow and improve. There is an infinite universe out there to study, and who knows what new discoveries await us.